Let us look at the next section, students. This section contains four questions. Each question has four options which contains matching from list 1 and list 2. So we have to select the correct match. Okay, let us look at question number 33 now. List 1 contains different equilibria while list 2 contains the factors affecting those equilibria. Let us look at the first reaction now. So option P. So HCN is in equilibrium with H plus and CN minus. So option 1, it says small increase in pH shifts equilibrium to the right. Students, if there is an increase in pH, it means that OH minus is added. So if OH minus is added, then this reaction will move in the forward direction. So P has to be matched with 1. If we talk about the second option now, small decrease in pH shifts the equilibrium to the right. So if the pH decreases, it means that H plus ions are getting added. So if H plus ions are getting added, the reaction will move towards the left hand side and not to the right as mentioned. So second will not be a match. If we talk about the third option now, increasing temperature shifts the equilibrium towards the right. This has to be a match, students. And if we talk about the fourth option now, adding ammonia shifts the equilibrium to the right. So if we talk about ammonia, ammonia is basic. So it is equivalent to adding OH minus. So the OH minus will consume this H plus and this reaction will move in the forward direction. So P has to be matched with 4 as well. So in the back of our heads, we can clearly see that option C and option D cannot be the answer. So answer has to be one of A or B. Let us look at the reaction given in option Q now. So in option Q, we have zinc sulfide dissociating into zinc 2 plus and H2 minus aqueous. Okay. So option 1, it says small increase in pH will shift the equilibrium to the right. So when there is an increase in pH, students, we must have added OH minus, or the OH minus concentration must have increased. If the OH minus ion concentration increases, the zinc 2 plus will start to precipitate. So zinc 2 plus will consume the OH minus, giving us zinc hydroxide. So due to this reaction, the zinc will get consumed, which will lead to the reaction shifting in the forward direction. So one will have to be matched with Q. If we talk about the second option now, small decrease in pH shifts the equilibrium to the right. So if we talk about the decrease in pH, it means that H plus ions must have been added. So when this H plus ions are added, it is the sulfide ion which will consume this H plus, forming bisulfide or H2S, whatever may be the case. So the sulfide ions will get consumed. So this will also lead to the forward shifting of this equilibria. So Q has to be matched with 1 and 2 as well. If we talk about the third option now, increase in temperature will shift the equilibrium to the right. This is a sparingly soluble salt. The increase in temperature will cause an increase in the solubility. So 3 has to be matched. And if we talk about the fourth one, adding ammonia shifts the equilibrium to the right. So this is also correct, students. Adding ammonia will cause an increase in the pH. So as per the first option, this will also be the match. So Q has to be matched with 1, 2, 3 and 4. So the correct answer has to be option A. Let us look at the option R and option S now. So for option R, we have H2PO4 minus, giving us HPO42 minus along with the liberation of H plus ion. If we talk about the first one, the small increase in pH shifts the equilibrium to the right. So if we talk about the increase in pH, so increase in pH, it means that OH minus is being added. So when OH minus is added, students, this H plus will be consumed. And when this H plus is consumed, students, this will cause the forward shifting of this reaction. So one is going to be a match, student. If you talk about the second option now, small decrease in pH shifts the equilibrium to the right. So if there is a decrease in pH, we are adding the H plus, students. So if the H plus is being added, this equilibrium will not be shifted towards the right. If you talk about the third option now, increasing the temperature shifts the equilibrium to the right. This is also correct, students. Weak species generally have an increase in their dissociation constant with the increase in temperature. So third will be a match, students. And if we talk about the fourth option now, so the fourth option is similar to the first option. Adding ammonia makes the medium basic, and when the medium is basic, students, the H plus ions on the right hand side will get consumed, which will lead to the forward shifting of this equilibrium. So four will also be match, students. And if we talk about the last one, which is the S, so we have Na2CO3 plus H2O giving us NaHCO3 and NaOH. So this is the hydrolysis reaction, students. If we talk about the first option now, small increase in pH will shift the equilibrium to the right. So when increase in pH, the OH minus ion concentration will increase. So the reaction will not move towards the forward direction. It has to move in the backward direction. So one will not be a match, student. If we talk about the second option now, second option will be a match. When there is a small decrease in pH, it means that we have added H plus ion. So the H plus ions which are further added will react with this NaOH and move this equilibrium in the forward direction. So 2 will be a match. If we talk about the third option now, third will also be a match. The hydrolysis reactions are endothermic, and on increasing the temperature, the hydrolysis or the extent of hydrolysis is going to increase. Okay. If we talk about the fourth option now, the fourth option is very similar to the first option. So adding ammonia will make the medium more basic, and as a result, the OH minus ion concentration will increase and the reaction will move in the backward direction. So students, we have the correct match for this question, and we have to mark the answer as option A. Let us look at the next question now. Question number 34. So list 1 contains some reaction while list 2 contains equivalent masses of these reactants. Select the correct match. Students, we need to figure out the molar masses of the species given on the left, and we need to figure out the N factors. So we can first start with the molar masses, students. So the molar mass of P, which is Fe2C2O4 whole thrice, the value of M is equal to 376. If you talk about option Q now, we have FeC2O4. The value of molar mass is equal to 144. If you talk about the R option now, students, we have Na2HPO4. The molar mass of this species is equal to 96 and 46, which is 142. And if you talk about the last option now, we have thiosulfate S2O3 2 minus. The molar mass of this species comes out to be equal to 112. So we have the molar masses now, students. We just need to figure out the N factors. So in the first option, we have iron already present in a state of plus 3. So the iron is present in a state of plus 3 only. So there is 3 oxalate ions, and all of these oxalate ions are converted into CO2. So the N factor is going to be equal to 6 in this case. So if X is equal to 6, so if we talk about the equivalent weight, it will come out to be equal to 376 by 6, which gives us a value equal to 62.67. If we talk about the second reaction now, so in this case, the iron is present in a state of plus 2. So iron is also getting oxidized in this case, unlike the previous case. So if you talk about the N factor now, we have 1 oxalate and 1 iron. So the N factor is equal to 3. So if we talk about the N factor, it is equal to 3. So the equivalent weight will come out to be equal to 144 by 3, which is equal to 48. So students, P was matched with 4, Q is matched with 3. So we can clearly see that the answer has to be option D. Let us look at Na2HPO4. So students, Na2HPO4 is converting into H3PO4. This is an acid-base reaction. It is gaining 2H+. So the N factor is going to be equal to 2. So equivalent weight will be equal to 142 by 2, which is equal to 71. So students, R has to be matched with 1. And if you talk about the last option, which is the thiosulfate. So in thiosulfate, average oxidation state of sulfur is plus 2. It is going into plus 6. So if you talk about the N factor, students, it is equal to 8. Each sulfur is losing 4 electrons, and there are 2 such sulfur present in the molecule. So X is equal to 8. Molar mass was 112. So the value of E will come out to be equal to 112 divided by 8, which gives us a value equal to 14. So students, S has to be matched with 5. So the correct matching is P with 4, Q with 3, R with 1, and S with 5. The answer for this question has to be marked as option D. Let us look at the next question now. Question number 35. So list 1 contains some molecules or ions, while list 2 contains some properties. Select the correct match. So students, if we talk about N2, so the N2 bond order is equal to 3. So for P, the bond order is 3. The HOMO, or the highest occupied molecular orbital, is equal to sigma 2pz. Okay, whereas the LUMO, or the lowest unoccupied molecular orbital, is pi star 2p. If we look at the matchings, so ionization increases bond order. So this will not be a match, students. The highest occupied molecular orbital is the sigma 2pz. So if the species is ionized, the electron will be lost from the bonding molecular orbital. So ionization will decrease the bond order. So 2 has to be a match. And if we talk about the HOMO LUMOs, the correct match is HOMO is sigma and LUMO is pi star. So 3 also has to be matched to it. So matching for P is 2 and 3. So we can directly eliminate option A and option C, students. Let us look at O2 minus now. So for O2 minus, we have bond order equal to 1.5. So the highest occupied molecular orbital is the pi star 2p. And if we talk about the lowest unoccupied, it is the sigma star 2p. So if we talk about the ionization, the upon ionization, the electron will be lost from the pi star. So it means that the ionization is going to increase the bond order. So one has to be a math student. And if we talk about the homo-lumo combination, so the homo is pi star, whereas the lumo is the sigma star. So 4 has to be matched, students. So we can clearly see that the answer to this question is most likely B. Let us look at the R option now. So in R option, we have C2. So if we talk about C2 now, students, so C2 has a bond order equal to 2. So the homo is the pi 2p, whereas the lumo is the sigma 2p. So if we talk about the ionization will decrease the bond order. So 2 has to be matched, students. There is no corresponding match in terms of homo and lumo. If we talk about the last option, which is the Be2 plus now, students. So in Be2 positive, we have the homo as sigma star, lumo is the pi. So there is again no match corresponding to homo and lumo. So we can just talk about the bond order. So if we ionize it, so upon ionization, the electron will be lost from the sigma star. So this means that the bond order is going to increase. So for S, only correct matching is option 1. So we have the correct match now, students. As seen before, the answer is option D. Let us look at the last question for the test, students. Question number 36. An aqueous solution of X is slowly added to an aqueous solution of Y as represented in list 1, while the variation in conductivity after a small time interval is given in list 2. So we have to talk about the increase in conductivity after a small time interval. So we have to select the correct match. So let's start with the P option now. We have acetic acid and NaOH. So X is slowly added to an aqueous solution of Y. Okay. So we have NaOH present, and to this NaOH we are adding CH3COH. Okay. So NaOH will be dissociated, students. It is a strong electrolyte, so it will be 100% dissociated. So upon addition of CH3COH, what is going to happen is neutralization will take place, and then OH minus will be replaced with acetate ions. Okay. So students, the conductivity is going to decrease till the neutralization point, and after the neutralization point, the conductivity will not change much. Okay. So P has to be matched with option 4, students. If we talk about the second option now, which is Q, so we have the reverse case now. So we have CH3COH kept in the beaker now, whereas NaOH is getting added. Okay. So this is a weak electrolyte, but upon the addition of NaOH, the conductance is going to increase, students. So the conductance will increase up till the neutralization point, and after the neutralization point, when all of acetic acid has been consumed, after that, addition of further NaOH will lead to a further increment in the conductivity of the solution. So it will increase and then increase more rapidly. So this has to be matched with option 3. So Q has to be matched with option 3, students. The answer is most likely B. Okay. If we talk about R option now, we have two weak species in this case. We have acetic acid, which is kept in the beaker. So to this, we are adding methylamine, CH3NH2, which is again a weak base. So weak acid, weak base. So weak acid was not very much dissociated, but due to addition of methylamine, the neutralization will happen, and till there is neutralization taking place, the conductivity is going to increase. Okay. But after the neutralization point, the addition of the weak base will not affect the conductivity much. Okay. So R has to be matched with 2, students. And if we talk about the last option, in which we have NaOH and NaCl, so there will be no neutralization taking place. NaCl is a strong electrolyte. NaOH is also a strong electrolyte. So upon addition of NaOH, the conductivity will keep on increasing. So S has to be matched with option 1. So students, we can clearly see that for this question, we have to mark the correct answer as option B. Okay. So this is it for today, guys. I hope the solutions were clear to you. Thank you.